let's begin by just telling the folks a little bit about the program. What is the Guardian Ad Litem program? Some of the things that you do.
Sure. We're a volunteer program through the judicial branch of government. We recruit, screen, train, and guide community volunteers to be advocates for children who have been abused or neglected and are in the juvenile court system due to that abuse or neglect. All those children are in the foster care system, so to say. They're in the custody temporarily of our local Guilford County Department of Social Services. Mm-hmm. And our volunteers, they advocate for children. They have two goals: getting these children into safe, permanent homes as quickly as possible outside of the foster care system. And the second goal is, while they're in the foster care system, that all of their needs are going to be met, that they have the rights and opportunities that any other child has.
Okay, well, it sounds like a very comprehensive service that you're in, and you've done this for a couple of years now. I believe you told me you've had three under your care. Tell us a little bit about the process, the training that's involved, the time commitment, those kinds of things.
I applied and interviewed in July of 2016. I began a training program that lasted for 6 weeks. We met for about 3 hour sessions each week for 6 weeks in a row. We attended court one day for a half day to see what is happening inside the family court here in Guilford County, and then wrote up a sample court report to substantiate and report on what had transpired in the cases we witnessed. At the end of that training period, we were then appointed, sworn in, and appointed to specific cases to represent specific children. And I have two cases. One is a case with one child, and the other is a set of siblings. Mm-hmm. So a total of three kids to advocate for here locally.
Okay. Now, who makes those decisions? Who determines when a guardian ad litem is needed, and who makes the assignment?
Every child who is brought into the court system due to an allegation or a petition alleging abuse, neglect, or dependency is automatically appointed our program to represent that child. So to equate it to something people are familiar with, if someone is commits a crime and cannot afford an attorney, or an alleged committed crime and they can't afford an attorney, they're appointed an attorney through the Indigent Defense Service. Mm-hmm. Similar to any child who's brought into the court system because of abuse, neglect, or dependency is appointed our program to be their representative. It's my job, along with my staff members, to recruit enough volunteer guardians ad litem to be able to represent each one of these children. And then it's my duty, along with our staff, to get to know our applicants, our community volunteers, and to best match them with certain kids and cases that fit their unique abilities.
Yeah, I was going to ask you do sort of match the GAL, the
Correct.
Guardian ad litem, to the specific case.
Yes, sir.
What sort of the qualifications are you looking for? What are the requirements for being a guardian ad litem?
Well, we're very inclusive. If you're over the age of 18, if you have a background that's free of criminal activity, then you are a candidate to become a guardian ad litem volunteer. Now, beyond that, we're looking for folks who have a sincere desire to help a child, mm-hmm. and that's number one. All of the children we're working with are victims of abuse and neglect, and we want them out of this system. So it takes someone who is willing to, as an advocate, stand up for the rights of that child and be able to come to walls at times and work to break down those walls and work within conflict and stand up for what's right for that child.